Hi, this is Trevor from DigiWorks. Today we are going to do something different than programming. What we are going to do is hacking a battery and making permanent power supply. In this way, we'll be able to use our camera permanently with AC power supply. I do this with LPE10 battery for my Canon EOS 1100. But what I'm going to do can be implemented for any other camera using this battery. Or using same method, you can do for any other different brand's camera too. By the way, there is an original Canon product for using the camera with AC power, but it's around $65. For me, it's a bit expensive for what it's doing, so not worth it. You can do this for $5 max. My aim is not only making something cheap, but also using my existing power supply and some electronic parts we can find at home. I spent $0 for this, but if I have bought these pieces, I would have spent roughly $5. Let's get started. First, we have to open a dead battery and replace it with a voltage regulator and DC plug. After taking the battery out, we can cut the battery connections. Fully charged battery is around 8 volts, so I will use 8 volts regulator. I cut the battery connections. But I will keep this small board for using later. In my electronic rubbish box, I have found a female DC socket which is compatible with my power supply's plug. I'm going to disassemble this for using in this project. I also need a hole for this plug. It looks okay. Now, we are going to use this little board for transferring the power supply's voltage to the camera. Red cable goes to B+, blue to negative. We can stick the board its place. I'm soldering red and blue cables to the socket like that, but it's not ready yet. If we leave like that, we have to have a special 8 volts regulated power supply. So we can't use any ordinary power supply. My aim was able to use any power supply from 9 volts to 15 volts, which I already have many. For making this, we are going to add very known voltage regulator LM7808. I have disassembled it from an electronic circuit, but you can buy for $5. Basically, when you apply an input voltage higher than output voltage, it provides stable output voltage, which is 8 volts in this context. I cut the red and blue cables and inserted the regulator like that. Let's check if it's working, regulating. One of the power supply that I want to use for this project gives 17 volts. Let's check again on regulator. First pin is input, second is ground, third is output. As you see, it's 8 volts, nice. Before installing and fixing everything in the box, I want to verify on camera. My first try didn't work, because a lead protection switch wasn't pressed. When I pressed with a pen, it worked. Now we can start installation. I think it's time to remove this cooler before we start installation. So, shorten the cables and fitting the elements into the box. I am super fast sometimes. To see. I stick this socket with a glue. Because pressure is exerted on the socket when we use it, I've used a matchstick as seen here to provide the necessary tension required. Then I fix this matchstick with a glue. As we have some space in the box, I prefer adding a cooler for the regulator to make it more reliable. For this, I'm going to use a piece of copper sheet as cooler. If you use this with a 9 volts power supply, probably it's not necessary. But I want to use it with different power supplies. I have a 12 volts, another 17 volts. This is why I preferred using this small copper sheet as a cooler. I also stick a piece of paper behind the cooler. I give some funny shape for better airing. And sticking all together. I just think that it could be better if we have two aeration holes here. Just like that. I think now it's time to close this battery box, stick the edges, and start using. Before finishing, we need to do two more things. First, we have to remove the battery protection lid. It is very easy to disassemble and assemble. Secondly, we need to fit something that is easily removable into the lid control switch to ensure the camera that the lid is closed and everything is okay. Yeah, that's all. Now and then, it can work non-stop. Thank you for watching.